So this input box is, you know, on the internet web application, there are many opportunities will wanted to ask user to input some number. For example, right here, I want to create input box, but at a form load event. All right, and the input box at the form load event. So the input box will prompt the user to enter a salesperson's name. All right, so form load means whenever you open your form, that's form load. Okay, so you're going to add the form load. You're going to enter a salesperson's name and the title. So for this, take a look this input box. The title is called name entry. Name entry, and then the prompt. That's a question. Say the question is enter the salesperson's name. All right. So now. So there, the OK button and the cancel button are come from this input box. So I put my name, Xin Liu. So what will come out, then we want the result is in a label box called LBL salesperson, and say salesperson's name is Xin Liu. Of course, if you put right here Damien, the salesperson name is Damien. Daniel, the salesperson name is Daniel. Okay, so Angela will be Angela. So these will be based on the salesperson, sales, whatever you enter. You interact with user. So you need to create a solution file named input box solution and input box project. All right. So you need to have two label box. One is called LBL name, salesperson's name. All right, so this one right here, okay, LBL name, salesperson's name. And the other one will be your name and the ID number. You got to put your name and ID number. So let's take a look here right now. So this one, all right, we're going to make you code like this. So you're going to have a local variable called string salesperson. It's okay. Then class variable. So class variable is private. You put private string salesperson as string. Then you learn this right now. You learn this, okay? Alright. So string salesperson equal. Alright. So that string salesperson, that variable equal to input box. Enter salesperson's name. This one is the prompt. Okay, right here, the prompt, the question you want to ask. And name entry is the title. All right, so I guess I repeat this several times. And then you want to pull this right here. Okay, so LBL name dot text equal LBL name text. The text right here, we already put salesperson's name. You see LBL name already. So you already put salesperson's name right here. And you're going to connect with string salesperson's name. So this time is Xin Liu. And I want to ask you, do you understand this? Okay, so let me ask you a question right now. What we're going to learn today? Anybody? Question, what we learned today? Anybody? What we learned today? Question, are you there? Angela, can you tell me what we're going to learn today? Anybody can write on here, the Zoom? A special function called what? Anybody can remember? I just say it. No. All right. Input box, Xiang. Good job. We are learning input box. What does input box do? What does input box do? What does input box can do? Anybody tell me? Dylan? Anybody? Alright, so input box can display a dialog box. Dialog box means you want to get the input from user. You display a dialog box and you're going to retrieve the input. So this is a input box, will be a dialog box, and this is input, we retrieve it. After we retrieve the input, we are going to put your class variable right here. Then right here we're going to tell you here. Okay, so first of all, if you put like this way, enter salesperson's name entry, this will be longer. So we are going to learn to make the code clear and easy. So we're going to do this. We're going to say this. We're going to create something called string prompt and string title. All right. So that once we have string prompt and string title, we're going to say const string prompt as string enter salesperson's name. Const string title as name entry. So instead of this, we put string salesperson equal input box string prompt and title. Prompt means the question. And this will be the code. And also, if we want to move to next line, you are going to do this. Okay, name and next line called control chart new line and enter this. And with your student ID number, all right, so So I explain this one right now, and I am going to